In this lesson, you'll learn how to optimize your pages for different screen sizes, including the difference between CSS and device-independent pixels, and how to choose the right sizes for your elements.
And at the end of the lesson, you'll build the mobile version of the hometown site. Now, when I'm working on my sites, sometimes I notice that content seems to flow off the page, or I have to pinch and zoom to see anything. What's going on here?
Well, besides your CSS, which could use a little bit of work, the biggest problem is that you don't have the viewport set properly. The viewport defines the area of the screen that the browser can render content to. Here, let me show you an example. In my laptop, I've sized the browser window to 800 pixels wide, which makes my viewport 800 pixels. If I expand the width, the viewport size changes, and now I have a viewport width of 1,000 pixels.
All right, well, that seems simple enough. But not all displays have the same pixel density, right?
Right.
Like, what about something like your Chromebook pixel display?
Right. Well, the Chromebook pixel display tells me that it's got a width of 2560 pixels by 1700 pixels. But when I make the browser window the full width and ask for the viewport width, it tells me it's only 1280 pixels wide.
Wait, not the full 2560?
Nope, not at all.
Well, not all pixels were created equal, were they?
Exactly. A pixel isn't always a pixel.